Season 1, NS Hosa, Axiom Acer, MVB, FX Open, LGIM, Azubu, Prime, StarTail.
Shakshi has been called out as the second NS Hosa player. They are pulling no punches today, sending out Mad Bull first. He was able to get multiple kills, 2 points on the scoreboard, and instantly they pick their most skilled, most accomplished player.
Shakshi with another Terran versus Terran. He's up against the Marine King. So far, we've seen a lot of Terran players for the Prime team. Now their strongest one is out to face Shakshi.
Yep. Shakshi is a great Terran versus Terran player. Marine King, though, on the other hand, has more results and is also a fairly strong Terran versus Terran player. You can't count him out here.
Exactly. Marine King now plays on a Whirlwind, the map of choice for Shakshi.
Whirlwind is such an exciting map for Terran versus Terran. We've seen so much late game on this map with Sensor Tower rings, with the fights usually revolving around that Sensor Tower or the Zelnaga Watchtower in the middle of the map.
Terran versus Terran in general in Heart of the Swarm is really interesting to watch. There are a lot of very technical strategies that you can execute. At the beginning it was all about the Hellbats, but right now there are so many different things that you can actually do. Even the Banshee play is coming back with a Vengeance again, a strategy that is being played by a lot of the Prime Terrans, so you might see it coming out of Marine King here, but this is definitely a cool match to watch. There's so much that really hangs in the balance when those two face each other in this scenario.
Yeah, so much does. It's really important for Prime to get as many wins on the scoreboard as they are down right now. If Shakshi wins this, of course, puts them just 1 point away from taking the Team League match. This is the GSTL. It's time for Marine King up against Shakshi. Terran versus Terran coming at you guys on Whirlwind. See you in the game.
The third Terran player that Prime sends out against NS Hosa starts to the top right of Whirlwind. We have the one and only
Marine King Prime.
Marine King played once this season, was a starting player for the Prime team, StarTail, lost to Golden right away. Sorry, he won against Golden, but lost to Avenged, my bad. He's up against the Terran, the top left in blue. For NS Hosa, we have
NS Hosa Shakshi.
And Shakshi came out twice this season. He played in the match against StarTail, and he also played in the match against Azubu. He played against Terran players both times, lost against Sound and against Ganji. So this is the third TBT that he plays in the GSTL. His record so far in this matchup is 0-2 this season. Needs to step it up a bit for his team here.
Yep, stepping it up 100% is what he needs to do. And we have both players actually going for a early barracks. So no CC first, which is what you would have expected from Marine King, as greedy as he is. And it's just a normal barracks timing. In fact, no early gas.
Yeah, Marine King goes for the gas right away, though. So he's taking the refinery now, as does Shakshi. And we talked a bit about the matchup in Terran versus Terran. And especially the Prime players, the Prime Terran, seem to be really fond of starting with Banshees again, a build that has been disappearing for quite some time. But now, especially Byun is using it quite a lot, and it's very strong if executed well. Might be something that Marine King is going to use here.
Yeah.
But of course, we have so many different early pressure builds in Terran versus Terran now in Heart of the Swarm.
What we're going to see from Shakshi is his trademark. We've seen him do this already in the qualifiers. He shows this build a lot in Terran versus Terran, the reactor expand. And Marine King actually puts his own reactor down, so we could see this from both players. The timing of the reactor for Shakshi finishes, he has 50 gas around the same time his first Marine pops out, so he kind of lines it up, gets that reactor out, and we even have a second barracks coming down from Marine King. So strange.
Really interesting. Marine King with the second barracks very early in the game here, so going for some pressure. One of the things that I have to say about Shakshi, just a fun fact in case you guys didn't know, he was the youngest player to ever win a GSL before Life won the championship against MVP. Back in the days, Shakshi successful against Leanog in the finals. Was quite a surprise that he was able to win. Everyone back then said that Leanog was the one to win the season and claim the title. But it was actually Jokchi who was able to take this the championship. And back then he was 17 years old. And now we have Marine King actually going into double Reapers, and
yeah.
This could be so dangerous to Jokchi.
I think it's going to be triple Reapers when that third or when the second barracks finishes. Of course, the reactor he can make two at a time. He's supply blocked, but he does have a Reaper queued up. There it is, three at a time. This is really scary. Jokchi did not go into that reactor build that I was talking about, though. He did get a factory, so this is going to help him a little bit against defending this, but this is going to still be very, very difficult. Yeah. This is such an unusual build.
You know, when you start with the command center first or with the barracks into expand in this matchup, then you will lose immediately to such a aggressive Reaper build. There is, it's a complete blind counter. So in this scenario, Jokchi has a better position than he would have if he would have started with an early expand. But still, it's something where he will struggle a little bit because Reapers also do a significant amount of damage against Hellions.
Yeah, and they also do a significant amount of scouting, which may cause a problem because we're going to see a Hellbat drop, it looks like, from Jokchi here. He's hiding his armory at the natural, so it's a little bit harder for Marine King to spot it. Marine King has not shown his Reapers yet, and he could come in here with it looks like seven at a time if he hits this just right.
Mass Reaper builds are really scary, and there we go. The Hellion is out. The Reapers, are they going to commit? There are five of them, and he is moving in. He's trying to take this out. Both of the Marines are already gone, as he's trying to chase all of those Hellions.
Very aggressive play here by Marine King. Now just pulling his Reapers back, letting them heal. He has to be very careful against the lineups, though, on those Hellions.
Yeah, nice kill so far. Doesn't see the armory just yet. He might be able to spot it with one of those Reapers if he tries to jump up the cliff, but he doesn't.
Yep, three more Reapers coming in, and this is going to give him a total of seven. He will be able to continue the attack, but Hellbats are on the way, and that's going to be something he can't fight directly with the Reapers.
The Hellions were already repaired. He needs to have nice micro. He needs to split those units if he really wants to be successful with the Reapers. The Hellions, if they get few shots off, then they will be too much, and Marine King apparently is calling it a day, at least for now.
Yeah, with the Reapers, he stops the production. He gets just two more out, now going into Marines and Stim. And he didn't see the armory, so he is still a little bit vulnerable to that Hellbat attack, which is obviously very significantly delayed by the Reapers, but still is quite potent. And Reapers are not going to be what you want to defend against this because they can't kill the medevac. And also, if you fight a Hellbat with a Reaper directly, especially the new Reapers, it's not pretty.
Yep. Marine King really gambling a little bit with this opening, hoping for Jokchi to play a greedy and economy-based build, which did not occur. Jokchi now in a position where he can do a lot of damage with the Reapers. We have the first Widow Mines coming in, though, and with the Widow Mines he can at least do some damage against the medevac, but there's just way too many Hellions now.
Very important supply block here for Jokchi. It's going to mean that he only has two Hellbats going into the attack.
That's definitely going to be a bit of a problem. In small numbers, Reapers are really good against Hellions, but as soon as you have a lot of Hellions available with Reapers and them stacking up, you can't really deliver the damage that you need to before the area of effect for the Hellion kicks in.
This is interesting. He actually does end up waiting for the next two. I thought he was going to go faster with this. But with two Vikings, he can also put them into assault mode. Marine King has a lot of units because he has two barracks, obviously, and he still has those Reapers to help defend, but he's starting to get now Marauders and a decent Bio Force that should be able to, especially with Stim, deflect the attack if he's at home. But if he moves across the map or if he's out of position, this can still do a ton of damage.
Marauders are going to help him a lot, and here we have the medevac for Marine King. If he gets those Reapers into the main base of Jokchi, then it's going to be devastating, but first of all, he has to defend against those two guys.
Yep, there's the first Widowmine shot.
Uh-oh.
Oh no, he's got nothing nearby.
There's nothing to defend.
This is going to be devastating, but the attack is on. The Reapers are over at Jokchi's base. He's about to run up.
That's too much.
He has Stim.
All those SCVs are going to die, but he doesn't see it. He actually does walk by. And now we have the transformation of some... No, actually, he only built a few of them, but yeah. Oh my god, this is way too much.
The siege tank is the most important part. A pull here on the SCVs by Jokchi. Great surround. Now the Hellbats can do their work. A good lift by Marine King, however.
Yeah, supply-wise, we have the NSO supply up a little bit. Marine King is losing a lot of harvesters, but so is Jokchi. Both of them down to 14.
Oh, he gets a good connect on those SCVs, though.
Eight harvesters left, but we have, of course, the double command center here for Marine King.
Oh, Marine King losing every single one of his harvesters. That is his last SCV, and it dies. He's now down to zero harvesters.
and he's going to lose a medevac here.
Oh, he needs to drop those Hellbats onto the blitz. Oh,
he gets them away. And he's not able to snipe the medevac just yet. Marine King can't produce anything. More and more units are being dropped to the top right, and Marine King lifts his buildings. He knows that he has to do damage right now. Jakji's only goal is to hold out for as long as possible, defend his base, and if he's able to pull this off, he will be so far ahead that it should be impossible for me to catch up.
You're absolutely right. There's now going to be four Hellbats in the main base, though, and this is going to be pretty easy for Jakji to defend, especially because a lot of these units are actually Reapers. They don't do a ton of damage.
Well, against they outrange. The problem is they are so much faster and they outrange their Hellbats, so they can actually take them down with ease.
Yeah, he's actually microing this extremely well, and an SCB line has to be pulled for Jakji. This is
Hellbats
really well done.
I'm not gonna win him this game. Hellbats are not enough. They are just way too slow and they don't have the range. He needs to micro well with his medivac, but that's exactly what he does. But the medivac is sniped! The Viking is there! Exactly when he needs it, and this means he only has two Reapers instead of eight.
That's all he has. That's literally the only two units he has on the map.
Oh, wow. Jakji with 46 supply against two. This game, this is over.
It's over. I mean, he can micro that Reaper to his heart's content. That Reaper right now has five kills to Corporal, but that's going to be the end.
The Reaper is gone. Marine King is a two supply. He's building two SCVs. That's all that he has. And both of the command centers have been hung.
GG.
Jakji with a victory. NS Hossa is up 3-1.
Really cool builder by Marine King. Very risky. And he just did not have anything at home when the Hellbats hit him. It was unlucky. Because he was going out for a really nice stim timing with his Reapers and his bio. But then when the Hellbats hit, he had nothing to defend. He didn't hit his timing either. And Jakji saw it. He scouted the attack coming across. So he had his Hellbats at the top of the ramp. And this is great for NS Hossa. They're actually one game away from defeating Prime and putting themselves on the scoreboard.
One game away, and I feel it can only be one of the one player coming to step into the booth right now. It has to be Kreator, in my opinion. But right now, looking at this, I mean, look at the Prime coach here, look at Gerard. He is really in a position where he's like, why is this happening? This shouldn't happen.
This is such an awesome day for NS Hossa. They are so far ahead now, and Prime has to choose their final player. And do they want to put Kreator out? I think it's the best option for them. He's a good all-around player.
Exactly. You need an all-around player. I think he's the best option that they have. And he's already sitting to the left side of the bench.
Right next to the coach, as if they've been having a chat. With his glasses on as well, so that does dispel the LASIK rumor we were throwing around earlier.
Yep. Has his glasses back on. And there's Jakji. He was talking to Matt Bull earlier. Matt Bull delivering two victories for his team, and now Jakji with the third one. They are one game away. Well, one game, and then they will finally have their first win in the GSTL.
Yeah, this is all that the last player they choose is all that Prime can rely on to take out multiple players, three of them, including Jakji.
And the cool thing for NS Hossa is now, once the player is revealed, they are in the position where they can map out everything. They can look at the games and they can be like, okay, who's confident against this race, against this guy? Which maps do you guys want to play? They can map out everything and really talk about strategies, talk about maybe timings, maybe some sneaky builds, and really determine the maps, the players, everything, mapping it out already, which will give him quite the edge. So this is a scenario, it couldn't be better for NS Hossa, but still, they've been all killed twice.
They have.
It stings. And today, it also leaves you with a very bad taste in your mouth, so you have to be very careful. You know, okay, we still have three chances to win this, but we should be careful about it and not be condescending.
You're right. Today is their day so far, but Kreator wants to end it. He stands up, walks to the booth.
It has to be him.
It's the most logical choice.
It's the most logical choice, and it is the only choice that they have. And now we have Kreator up against Jakji. And Gerard, he's troubled. He knows that this is a very tense situation for his team. Kreator is the one that they rely on now.
You can see Kreator's win rate in the GSTL is pretty decent, and his best position is last. He has come out last for his team four times, and not a single time has he lost. 4-0 when coming out as the closer. So an excellent choice for him here.
This is now a situation where Kreator can choose the map, but if he defeats Jakji, then in the next two games he will not be able to have the map pick. Map pick will go to NS Hossa, so this is really, really important now. Kreator, I don't envy him, not at all. He has to defeat three opponents, and NS Hossa today is looking like a completely different team.
Yeah, a completely different team. We've only seen two players, but the finesse that we've seen from these two players is incredible. The build order choices, And, you know, for Mad Bull, especially the patience that we saw, it's out of this world. This is not the Inesosa that we've been seeing so far this season. This is not the Inesosa that got all killed twice. This is a team that has put themselves together and are now one win away from taking their first win this season in the pennant race.
Jakji against Trader, Protoss versus Terran on Aquilon Waste. The next map that we are going to see here, the fourth map. No, the fifth, actually.
Yes, the fifth map. Perhaps our final map. Two-player map.
Trader won WCS Korea last year. He also placed second at the WCS Global Finals.
Yeah, he was doing extremely well in 2012 and wants to continue this in a new expansion, in a new year. Jakji has a tough task to defeat this strong Protoss player, an upgrade-heavy, late-game-oriented Protoss versus Terran player. Jakji has a lot of different builds he can use, and even if he loses here, he knows he has other players he can rely on.
Yeah. The game is going to start in just a second. This could be the last game of the day. Will Inesosa finally break the curse? They are up against Prime. 3-2-1. It is Jakji. He's up versus Trader. Now the last player for the Prime team. And we are jumping into the game right away in the GSTL Call of War.